Another extremely popular tracking technique is four-corner pin tracking. So you see we are slowly getting more markers, so one-point tracking, two-point tracking, and now four-point tracking or four-corner pin. And well, four-point tracking is, as I've said, very popular because you can well, you can do a lot of things with that. For example, you can put some video or text or whatever onto the display of this laptop. Or, for example, also used often if you want to replace the number plate of a car or, you know, whatever. I don't know. I mean, there are so many four-corner pin examples that you can use. So maybe let's just try that one. So let's say you have your shot with a person working on the computer and something has to happen on the screen. But well, in most cases, you probably won't just film it. It's a very commonly used technique to just add the content of the screen in post. And that's what we are going to do now. So maybe that can be a nice video on the screen or an image or text. I don't know. So what we want to do is to just replace this black square of this laptop, but without losing the reflection of this lamp in the background, because that would then not look very realistic. So you have to make sure to get the reflection and all that stuff. And you can do that by, well, with compositing. I'll show you later. So first of all, we have to track the four corners of this laptop. So I think that's very easy now. So you, of course, just go to the movie clip editor, then click on open, then navigate to the folder with your footage, load that footage, open clip. And it would be nice if Blender had a button to just match the movie length, but well, currently that is not the case. So we just have to see how long this movie is. So this is 189 frames. So bring the mouse over here, then in the timeline, press E for end frame, and then shift left arrow to go to frame one, maybe full screen, and then hit Alt A to playback to have it cache into the RAM. Now you saw here that there was a problem with FFmpeg, and that is something that I encounter very often. So when I scrub through the shot without having it loaded first, then something's wrong with the cache. So in that case, if you have problems with the loaded QuickTime, then you can go to footage settings and click on the reload button. And that will reload everything and the RAM will be recalculated. So Alt A again, and this now plays back better. Okay, so we've got the footage here and we have to track the four corners of the laptop. So that's very easy to do now. We just go here, maybe zoom in a bit, Control left click to place the marker here, let go, and this should track just fine. Maybe to concentrate on that, press L to lock that to this marker, and then hit Control T, and it's already finished. So maybe go through the shot, and this looks pretty nice. Okay, so that is marker one. Or maybe we can give it a name too. So this is the lower left. Now, next marker, right here in the corner. And maybe we can also change the speed. So just to be able to follow that better while it tracks, you can go down here to the tracking settings. And then here in the speed, you can switch from fastest to real time or half the speed or so. So Control T again, and now we can follow it much better and see how it tracks. So if there are some jumps or if it slides away, we can see that better. All right, in fact, there was some sliding. You can see that that is not in the corner anymore, but still I think it's, oh, maybe we can do it again. So G and move it a little bit backwards and then Command or Control T again. And I think that looks better now. So there's now not so much sliding anymore. And that is the upper left corner. Right, then shift left arrow to go to frame one. Add a marker here, like so. And if you now hit Control T, it will track, and this is in fact sliding now. So we have to track that again, maybe place the marker a bit better, like so. And I think that it might be better if we scale it up a little bit. So press S to scale it up. By scaling it up, you make, in relation to this pattern, you make this corner a bit sharper. So you can see how this will now be sharper than if it would be smaller. So maybe scale it up just a little bit and then hit Control T again. Oh, still some sliding, but I think it's fine. So that is the upper right. Go to frame one again. Control T, scale it up just a little bit, then move it right here in the center. Control T again. Yeah, should be fine. And that is lower right. Okay, so that is the four markers and we are done with tracking. So we can press L to unlock. And now we can go to the reconstruction panel to turn these four tracks into empties. So start up here, link empty to track, link empty to track. And little trick, Shift R will repeat the last operator. So now we have three markers here, then select that one. So Shift R for repeat last operator is maybe a little bit faster in this case than always pressing on this button. So Shift R again, and now we have lower left, lower right, upper left, upper right. Okay, so we are finished here and we can go to the 3D viewport. And again, just like before, Alt R, Alt G, GZ5, then delete the cube. 0 to look through the camera, N for the sidebar, enable background images, add image, movie clip for the camera, choose the clip, full screen, zoom in. Okay, so we've got the markers here in our corners and it looks great, but still we don't have a movie inside of this screen, of course. So first we have to insert a plane. And this plane can then get a texture with a movie on it. So with a 3D cursor here at the origin, we hit Shift A, add mesh plane. And now we have to try to snap the corners of this plane to these empties. And that's very easy. We just select these empties and then hit Shift S, then 3, cursor to select it. Now we have the cursor here and we can select the corner in edit mode of this plane. Select this corner, then hit Shift S2, snap selected to cursor, and now it sits there and we can move on. So tap to go out of edit mode, then select this empty, Shift S3, select the plane, edit mode, Shift S2, and so on. So now we have the corners here in the corners of our laptop, which is fine, but we have to attach that. And in this case, we don't do that with a constraint. Now we have to really somehow deform our plane by using these empties. And to do that, we will use something called hooks. And that works like this. First, you select the hook or the object that will be the hook for the vertex. In that case, it is the upper left corner. So you select that. Then Shift right click select the plane. Tap to go into edit mode, then select this corner, and then hit Control H, and then choose Hook to Selected Object. And that will attach this vertex to this empty, to this object. And if you hit Alt A now, you will see that this corner is now sticking to that empty. And that is exactly what we need. So we just repeat that with these other three corners. So select this one. Then Shift right click select the plane, edit mode, then Control H, hook to selected object, and now repeat that. Shift select, tap, Control H, hook to selected object, select, Shift right click select, tap, select, and Control H, hook to selected object. And now it just sticks to the monitor. And it looks like as if it would have a 3D track, But we don't. It's just this plane being deformed by these empties. So now what's left for us to do is to apply the movie. And maybe we can, I don't know, maybe we can playback Syntel or Big Bug Bunny. So let's assign a material to this plane, new. And because we don't need any shading, we just need the texture. So here in the shading settings, we will set it to shadeless. So no specularity, no shadows, nothing, just the texture. And speaking of texture, of course, we have to add that. So go here, click on new, choose image or movie. And then here you can open the movie. So in this case, maybe we can use the Syntel trailer. So choose that, open image. And since this is a movie file, we do have the option match movie length in this case, which is very nice. So let's press this button, then auto refresh. Maybe look at the preview. So it's start frame one, of course, it's still black. So maybe we can give it an offset, maybe not as much. 200 could be fine. So there we've got something showing up, which is fine. But if you render that now with F12, then, well, the movie does show up, in fact, but it is kind of distorted here. So that looks kind of weird. And that is because the UV coordinates are somehow being distorted by the hooks. So if you have a look at the modifiers panel of this plane here, then you can see all these hooks, these hook modifiers here. You can collapse them. So these are the four hooks. And to get around this distortion, which is very similar if you would use the UV projection modifier, you can simply add the subdivision surface modifier, then set it to simple and increase the render settings to 4. And if you do that, then it will be all straight lines. So we've got the texture here on our plane, and the next thing would be to composite that. But well, looking at this render, we have this gray background, so that is not very nice. So just as before, we could either set the horizon color to black, or we can go to the shading panel here in the render buttons and enable alpha pre-multiplied, because that will not render the color of the sky, of the horizon color, but it will multiply the image with the alpha channel. So then you will get this black background, which is fine. All right, so now that we've got that, we could start compositing. Or maybe we can have a look at that in GLSL texture shading mode. So let's try that by going to the textured viewport shading. And then here in the sidebar of the 3D viewport, go to the display settings and switch the shading mode from multi-texture to GLSL. And that will show you the movie, even though it is still distorted, but that is just because we have the subsurface modifier at level 1. So if you would increase that, you can see how these lines now also straighten up. So Alt A to playback, and we've got our movie playing back, and we have the plane animating here with the hooks. So that's pretty cool. And now let's start compositing that. So shift spacebar to go out of full screen, then control left arrow to go to the compositing layout. Now, of course, just as before, enable use notes, enable backdrop if you like, or just use the image viewer from down here, which you can also do. So if you have a viewer node, output viewer, then you can go here down in the image editor and enable viewer node to see what's inside here. So if you don't like to use the backdrop, you can also do that. So in this case, you would just see what's inside here. In this case, because we have this rather small layout, I want to use the backdrop. So let's do that. And then hit Shift A, input movie clip, then choose the movie clip, of course. Shift A, add distort scale, render size, use that. So this is now our render size. And now we have to somehow bring this footage over the monitor of the laptop. Now there are several ways to do that. Maybe let me first cut this, control left mouse button drag to cut this line. We can connect that later. So control shift left click on the render layer to view that. And well, we can now use the, for example, the alpha over node. So shift A, color, alpha over. So in this node can now be used to alpha over the render layer over the movie clip. So if you would do that, that kind of works and it works okay. But there is one problem, because if you look here in the footage, so just press H to hide this, we have the reflection of the lamp here. And we do need that to make it look realistic. And by rendering that on frame 90 with alpha over, you would lose this reflection of the lamp. So alpha overing just replaces the monitor with that image here. So I would not use that. I would use the mix node. So color mix. And since the output of the monitor is basically just light, we can also use a mode that is used to adding light. And since we are adding light, we can literally use the add blend mode. So bring that in here. And of course that too. And then set it to add. If you look at this, now it just adds the light of the render layer to that, and you still see the light of the reflection of this lamp. But currently on this frame, the movie is pretty dark because there is a cut. So maybe let's check on frame, what is it, 64? Okay, so there's title image. Okay, that's better. So here it really works. You have the reflection of the lamp. You do see the footage, so that is really working nicely. Well, I think we can improve that a little bit more by filtering that image, because if you look here, then it is really a little bit unsharp, a little bit soft here, the footage. But this is, of course, crisp because it is 3D. 3D is always crisp. So let's blur that, or at least filter it, by going to Shift A, filter, and then use the filter. And soften is exactly what we need here. So just drag that in here. Maybe factor one is a little bit too much. So if you want to compare, you can press M, M like mute. And I don't know if you can see the effect. Maybe if I zoom in by hitting Alt V. So that is with soften, and by pressing M, now you can see the effect. So I think 100% is a little bit too much, but maybe 50% might be just good enough. Or maybe 0.4. Okay, so basically I think that's it. So we can zoom out again by hitting the V key or by using the sidebar, and then here in backdrop, set the zoom back to 1. So that we see everything. And then before you start rendering, don't forget to actually connect the output of your last node to the composite output. So make sure that is connected. And then also let's set the correct resolution, either by going full HD, by just turning this up to 100, or by setting it to the 720p preset, which I want to use. And then don't forget to also set the correct frame rate. So the movie has been recorded with 25 frames per second, so you have to actually set it to 25 frames per second. All right, now let's also set an output path. So if you have saved the file already, and of course I've already done that, set it to a relative path. So slash slash render slash and then control F12. And when rendering has finished, then of course you can just go to the video sequence editor and play out the movie from there. Or you, if you just want to have a look, you can also use the movie clip editor. And that's what I'm going to do now. So go here to the movie clip editor, then just delete the link to this clip and then click on open, go to your render folder, select the first frame, open clip, full screen, TN to get rid of these panels. Then numpad 1 to watch it in the full resolution. Alt A to playback. And there's your finished four corner pin tracking. So that now also concludes the 2D tracking chapters. And in the next step, we will use some more trackers to reconstruct a 3D camera, so to create a camera solution.